Hello, and welcome to another Lumbridge Knight quest guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this video, we're going to be looking at the Goblin Diplomacy Quest. This quest offers some easy crafting XP, as well as some classic Goblin-related cutscenes. There are no requirements for this quest, but you will need the following items: a blue die, a red die, and a yellow die. We can get the three Goblin males during the course of the quest. A couple of energy or stamina potions will help speed things up, and a Falador teleport or two will help you when getting the dies. The fastest option would be to head to the GE and buy the three dies you need. The three dies will cost a total of around 1k coins. Let's start with the blue die. Head to Falador with 20 coins. Once there, head to Falador Park, head all the way to the east and enter the house there. Speak to Weissen, the head gardener, and ask him if you can buy some wood leaves from him. He will ask you how much you're willing to pay. Offer 20 coins and he will give you 2. Offer anything else and you will end up paying more than 20 coins. From here, head to Port Sarum or south of Varrok. South of Varrok, to the east of the Wizard's Circle where you defeated Delrith in Demon Slayer, you can pick red berries. So find the bushes and pick 3 sets of red berries. Alternatively, you can buy red berries from Wyden's food store in Port Sarum. From here, I'd use a home or Lumbridge teleport. From Lumbridge Castle Courtyard, head northwest to the vegetable patch behind Farmer Fred's house. Once here, pick 2 onions. Alternatively, you can head to the north of Rimmington to get 2 onions like we did in the Witch's Potion quest. Now that we have all the ingredients for the dyes, get 15 coins and head to Aggie in Draenor Village. Make one of each of the required dyes. Now pop a Falador teleport and head north past Doric's house and on into the Goblin Village.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Head to the back of the village and speak to either General Bentnose or General Wartface. Offer to help settle their argument and accept the quest, clicking through the rest of the narrative. Since we already have our dies, now we need to get our goblin males. Luckily, these can all be found in the village. The first can be found by searching the crate directly behind the general's house. To find the next one, head into the hut directly to the southwest of the general's house, search the crate inside, and you'll get the second set. The third and final male can be found by heading south to the watchtower just in front of the gate. Head up the ladder and search the crate you find inside. Now that we have all our goblin males, head back to the general's house. Once there, combine the red and yellow dies together to make an orange die, then use it on one of the males. After that, use the blue die on another of the males. This should mean we now have a blue goblin male, an orange goblin male, and a standard brown goblin male. Speak to the general and present the orange armour. Poor Grubfoot will then have the fun job of modelling it. After a short argument, the generals will request blue armour. Since that's already in our inventory, speak to them again, this time offering the blue armour. Go through the cutscene again, they won't like this either. Speak to them again a third and final time, offering them the standard brown set. Boom, they like this one, despite it being the one they already had. I don't know, goblins, eh? When the cutscene ends, the quest is completed. Well done. You'll get your 5 quest points, 200 crafting XP, and a gold bar. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope that this Goblin Diplomacy quest guide was useful. Please leave a comment with any feedback or questions, as I'm keen to hear them. And all that's left for me to say is I've been the Lumbridge Knight. Peace out, and thanks for watching.